Today, I will show you how to change in monoliths the limits of the logit-normal distribution for observations and individual parameters. Monoliths have built-in four most common distributions: normal, log-normal, logit, and probit. To learn more about them, listen to the feature of the week number 31. Logit transformation is used for model elements that have theoretical or empirical upper and lower bounds, such as saturation, biomarker levels, or tumor size. By default, the logit-normal distribution is bounded to a unit interval, a simple formula extended to any AB interval. In older versions of monoliths, this procedure required two steps, one within the interface and one within a structural model. But starting from the version 2019, I need just two clicks in the interface to modify the values of A and B. Before I show you how to do it, let me explain why it is important. The first reason is that models with bounds on observations or parameters are very common. For example, PD measurements of heart rate, blood pressure, or cholesterol level have typical known limits. Also, tumor size measurements can be often limited by the size of an organ where it grows. Moreover, baseline parameters and PD observations are connected, and so they have the same limits. Other typical examples of bounded parameters are phases in models of daily rhythms and reference scores, such as in psychiatric's case. The second reason is that meaningful bounds speed up the convergence of the SIUM algorithm because they narrow the parameter space from which it samples. Also, they can increase the accuracy of parameter estimation thanks to the additional information included in the statistical model. Now I will use two examples to explain you how to adopt the limits of the logit distribution in monoliths. The first example is a warfarin PK/PD model where PD observations are bounded. Warfarin is a widely used oral anticoagulant, and you can find on our webpage a case study dedicated to its PK modeling workflow. Prothrombin complex activity is often a PD observation because it represents the net effect of the synthesis of various clotting factors. It is usually defined as the percentage of the normal activity, which means that the observations lie between 0 and 100%. Let's see how to include these limits in a PK/PD project for warfarin in monoliths. To do it, I go to the Statistical Model and Task tab. In the Observation Model section, entry number 2 corresponds to the PD response. First, I choose the logit-normal distribution. A box with the minimum and maximum limits appears automatically next to the list, and I can modify the values very quickly by writing the new ones. The initial interval is 0.81.42. These are the smallest and the highest values present in the dataset. This can lead, however, to incorrect estimates, because PCA can read values up to 100. So setting meaningful limits is very important. Here, I put 100 as the upper limit. Additionally, in monoliths, it is easy to check what is the actual model definition by clicking the blue box formula, which shows right away the equation. In the second example, I explain you how to adopt the limits of the logit distribution for individual parameters. For this, I use a model of the QT interval. This interval is read from an electrocardiogram and characterizes electric properties of the heart. It is important because its prolongation increases the risk of a cardiac death. Typically, a model of the QT interval depends on the heart rate, denoted here by RR, and daily changes caused by the circadian rhythm. The circadian rhythm can be defined by phasor functions, and in the simplest case, it is characterized by an amplitude A and a phase phi. As amplitude can take all non-negative values, phases by definition belong to a 0 to P interval. As previously, in monoliths, this information is taken into account directly in the interface in the Statistical Model and Task tab. Now I go to the Individual Model section and choose the logit-normal distribution from the list for the phase parameter. A dedicated icon for settings appears automatically. When I click on it, a box with distribution limits pops up. I change the upper limit to 2 times pi, that is 6.28. I close the box and I check the formula for my transform parameters. Now I can go back to build my statistical model and run scenarios. Thank you for listening and have a good week.